The reason we said that is so that it's not conflict with what your teacher has been doing with you. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is letting objective. Letting what?
Objective.
So we're going to look at what are we going to achieve when we are done with this lesson. Whatever you do in life, you must be aiming at a purpose. You do not do anything without saying this is why you are doing it. So why are we doing this lesson? That's what we mean by lesson objective. Okay? So which day? We should be able to use verbs according to their numbers correctly. We use verbs according to their numbers how?
Correctly.
And that will now equip us. It will equip us and enable us to say that you didn't get it. When your dad says he goes to school every day. Someone is already laughing. Why is he laughing? He knows that expression is wrong. Am I right?
Yes.
He knows it is wrong, isn't it? But it is only today we are going to find out the reason why that expression is wrong. Because some of us actually know what is wrong, but we do not know why such things are wrong. We only know by intuition that when we hear such kind of expressions, something is wrong somewhere. Am I correct?
Yes.
Somebody is pinching this kid. Okay, bring it up.
Yes.
You want to give me some peas? Some peas? Peas of your biscuit? Okay, let's eat together. Now you take, I take. Alright, so the first thing we do is verbs appear in number in this form. Singular verbs. If you are done with the board, you can go.
Yes.
Everyone, look at the board. Singular verbs do what?
I agree with singular nouns or pronouns.
It's ridiculous. You have a friend and you want to offend the friend. You want to offend me?
No.
If you do not want to offend me, stop giving him a knock. I hate teaching with cane. I wasn't trained that way. Since all my life I've been teaching, I do not teach with cane. You want me to carry some long stick?
No.
Are you animals?
No.
Only animals that you teach with sticks. Okay? So stop teaching someone, otherwise I will hit you. And when I hit you, stand up, do the knock, your leader doesn't have any burglar footing. So when I hit you, you get out of the window and you fall into the other compound. Who would like to experience that?
No.
Nobody.
No.
Nobody, am I right?
Yes.
Okay. As we have said here, singular verbs agree with what? Singular nouns or pronouns. Of course. I need someone to reverse the statement. Let someone do a reversal. I need somebody to reverse it. You know what to call reverse? You're driving your car this way, you change the gear and the car starts going back.
Yes.
So someone tell me, if singular nouns agree with singular verbs, what is going to happen to singular verbs agree with singular nouns and singular pronouns in the reverse of now? What's your name?
Wednesday.
Angela. I prefer Angela because I heard Wednesday.
Wednesday.
And I was expecting Thursday. Angela, tell us the reversal. please warm your pants everyone. Warm your pants for Angela the Angie. Now at the count of three, you give her a beautiful applause. 1, 2, 3. Again. Thank you. So in the repressor, plural
breath. Esther, why are you pinching me this key?
I want you to look at my hands.
This is it. Jealousy, not jealousy. I know you said it's a short while ago, I didn't talk, but let me just correct it now. It is jealousy, not jealousy. If we speak this way, we will not be any different from those people who are at home. You know, there are some children at home now. They can't even get transport fare to go to school.
Jealousy.
Jealousy, not jealousy. So, the next step we have taken is that we have established that plural verbs agree with what? Plural nouns or plural pronouns. Is someone following me?
Yes.
Okay. The next thing we will do to achieve this objective is to give examples of singular verbs and plural verbs. Then we will proceed and conclude the lesson by showing examples of how this agreement is done. Quiz with me. Great. This guy is a wonderful video guy. Give him a round of applause. Give my video man a round of applause. Come on. This boy likes standing. Are you going to be a pastor?
Yes.
Want to be a reverend father?
Okay.
Engineer. Alright, so we need an example here. Singular. Verbs. And plural. Verbs. Going to rule it. The normal cross we use in primary school. I used this cross when I was also learning like you. To place ideas. Okay, so let's look at this. For example, the verb is going for one person. Is. Everybody say is.
Is.
When it is going for two people, it's not going to be is it. It's going to be are. Thank you. It's going to be are. So that's how verbs appear. Okay. Does is singular. Because we use it to talk about one person or one thing. Hello?
Hi.
Are we together?
Yes.
But your faces are mouthless. Your faces are what?
Mouthless.
Let's look at the word. Someone is going to learn a big word, a big new word from me today. Mouthless.
Mouthless.
What does it mean?
Mouthless.
No mouth.
It means gloomy. It means sad. Have I brought it down?
Yes.
Have I brought it down?
Yes.
Gloomy or sad? And that shows we are not communicating. Am I communicating to you?
Yes.
Then you cheer up. I need to see smile. Come on, smile. I love this boy's smile. Your smile can resonate in that. I am sorry. I have always thought you. Sorry, okay? Alright. So, now I need us to be
happy.
Excited. Thank you. And the rest of them. Okay, focus on one. Alright. So, does, what would be the plural of does when two people are doing something? Yes?
Do.
No.
Do.
No.
No.
Do.
No.
What did you say? Amaraji, what did you say? Okay, say Amaka.
No.
This is Amaka.
Yes.
Okay. What's your name?
Olivia.
That's the name of my last baby. I love the name Olivia. Okay? That Shakespeare is that any one of his books?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. You're going to read Shakespeare when you grow up. Okay? and get your secondary school. Various secondary schools, you must reach it. Very well. Okay, but if you tell me, what's going to be the plural of that when two people are doing something? They will. Olivia and
Sharon.
Sharon will dance the assignment.
We do.
So the plural of that is what?
Do.
Great. The plural of that is do. And how many of us know the novel Eze Goes to School?
Go.
Eze goes to school. You know the novel?
Yes.
How many people are going to school in that book?
Two or three.
Eze. Eze is the one going to school,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, now when you talk of Eze, Chima, and all those people that usually come to school with money in their pockets, but Eze didn't have money, all of them will dash to school.
Go!
Go, thank you. Go to school. Go. Okay. Alright. Steve.
See.
Olivia sees clearly with her pair of eyeglasses.
See.
Okay?
See.
Somebody was saying saw.
Ah!
Was it Angie that says saw? No, we're not doing present tense and past tense, remember. Okay? See. Tell me your name.
Doris.
Am I right?
Yes.
Doris, so what's going to be the plural when two people want to see something? Olivia.
See.
Thank you, Doris. See. See. Okay. Let's move on.
Jealousy.
He says a lot of useless things.
Say.
So, they
say.
Oh, we've got the idea now. So, should I just move on, go down?
Yes.
Now we've got the idea, we can place words into their singular and plural forms. Okay?
Yes.
Alright, so we go ahead to say, rice will be what?
Rice.
Great. Comes will be what?
Comes.
Okay. Six. Olivia sits.
Six.
Olivia sits in the second row. Six. Okay. Pains will be what?
Pains.
Alright. Pies will be what? Alright. How many of you combed your head this morning? Let me tell you one secret thing about the word which many Nigerians do not know. That word comb. The book is not articulated, okay? So you just kill it. Comb.
Comb.
Comb. Good. You guys are good. You have a diction teacher?
Yes!
I get it. That's a secret. I get it. Man or woman?
Woman.
They're all women.
Oh, they are women.
Yes.
Tell them they are
great.
Okay?
Yes.
They are awesome. Because I can see some things. I can see. Okay? Alright. So, some will become what?
Cook.
Alright. Cook. I don't see cook here.
I can cook.
Who cooks here? I cook. I'm a good cook. But can I tell you one thing? When I retire from teaching, I will start a restaurant. I'm going to cook
a restaurant.
I am going to cook
you invite
all types of Nigerian soups.
You invite me.
My wife and them will be serving people, and I will sit down and be counting the money. How many of you like money? You have money already somewhere. Tell me, what are you going to do with it? Buy ice cream. Buy Ausa canel. That canel that she has been eating. Two times. You were teaching it. I like that canel because it contains some kind of milk.
Yes.
A lot of milk. And it could be natural. You know, it could be healing. It could be a kind of healing something. So I love it. Now, what I wanted to say, which made me to talk about your money, is this. Do not spend money lavishly.
Yes.
Some of you, after eating, you still got take sweets.
Esther.
Don't know. So, do not waste your money, okay?
Yes.
Save. Do you know you can save money as a school child? I saw a video of a 7-year-old who started a business of collecting trash, plastics, and moving. Packaging it, gathering it one place, and you use a bag to tie it. And after he has got many bags, refuse collecting plants, come and carry it and sell it, and you will make money. 7-year-old. Who here has ever made one cover?
Me.
Made one cover from where?
From cheese.
From where? So not you push my video, man. Are you not videoing their heads? What did you make the money from? Okay, let me see. Come and show me. You got a business with you? Oh. So what does she sell?
Children made beads.
Goodness. So what does she sell?
Beads.
No. Do not invade her market.
Go ahead.
Nothing is here. All these Oh, you make this? You are the one making this? Oh. So when you make it, what happens? You sell it?
Yes.
What?
Can you see what this child can make? What's your name again?
Chiamaka
can make beads. Oh, this is near completion, made by Chiamaka. What's your surname?
Canelo.
Chiamaka Canelo made this big basic pie. This is wonderful. I love this. This is cute. Oh my goodness. Do you have anyone already committed here? Oh, I would have bought one. Okay, let's go back to our lesson. What Chiamaka is doing now is what we call something I mentioned to you earlier. Who can remember the word? Sit. Who can remember the word? Yes. You are almost there. Let me write it on the board.
Entree.
Everyone say entree.
Entree.
Entrepreneurship. That is the ability to have what it takes to do some, use some skills and do business. Chiamaka is already a businesswoman. And when she succeeds, and she starts pulling her legs up, 380, that time they would have made legs up 380. None of you should be jealous of her. And somebody would say, I remember that time in Harcourt, she was making this. Yes, that's how it begins. Do something. Let me tell you, education today is not about getting a certificate and getting employed and being paid some salary. You need to do something with your hands. So you are in school just to get the certificate, get the qualification, so that nobody will say, this one, he didn't go to school. That's why you are in school. So that nobody will say what? Look at this one, that did not go to school. But once you are in school, as you have started, Chiamaka, I encourage you to do it more and more. Okay? You are going to find another level, you will do it, and people will be looking for you. Alright? Somebody will say, want to come with Chevron or Mobile. It's not only Mobile, Chevron, and Total that can make you get money. What Chiamaka is doing, I so much commend it. I have a little baby. Okay, she's 7 now, she's no more lazy. Who is 7 yet? I have a 7-year-old that is good at plaiting hair. How did she learn it? When the mother is always lying down tired and the mother's hair is not done, she will be waving her hands there playing with it. Gradually, she's already learning how to plait hair and she can braid now. 7-year-old. And you know what I'm going to do for her? She's going to go to school. She's in the basic primaries now. Finish that, go to secondary school, from secondary school, go to university. No, she's in Lagos. Go to university, then I'll get some big money and open a hairdressing salon for her. Yes, that's what I'm doing. So when you see hairdressers, you now say they are illiterate people. It depends on the level you are doing it. Okay? Chiamaka can own a big making company. And when you want to wed, you will just go there. And she will give you album. You will say, make this one for us. She will charge you 3 million. And you are not bringing the cash. You will pay into the account. Then she will use her little car and come and drop it in your house 2 days to the wedding. And your wife will come, ah, happy, did he get it right? Then you place it and I say, ah, it's fine, I like it. It's fine. Who made it? And Chavaka will be there blushing. Madam, we made it. Ah, can you make for my sister who is wedding next month? Chavaka, more business has come, isn't it? All right. I love money. That was why I digressed. Let's go back to the lesson.
Cooks.
I told you I'm going to cook when I retire. That time gray hair has come. And I have to come like this. How are you?
How are you, my daughter?
You're very funny.
I will now be cooking. I love good food. If I cook a good soup for you, when you eat it, you remember the day they did your naming ceremony. There is this one that draws like liquid gum. How many of you?
No. Up on no.
No. When I cook it for you, you will start finding and losing the devil. So with that skill, or is it skill? Cook the tomato until it becomes pastry, like toothpaste. You now put vegetable oil and fry it and put all the things. When you eat my stew, your brain will open. So I'm going to cook. Chavaka is making beads, I will be cooking. So the couple that want to wed will invite us. You know what you're going to add to your bead making? Add deco into it. Decoration. Yeah, we do that. Decorate the hall, blue, red, green for them. Then I will use my van and bring the food for the wedding. Hey, Jesus. All right. Okay, now let's see how these things work. Are you with me, Sue?
Yes.
All right. Now let's say usage. Everybody say usage.
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 All right. Now we say, we choose the first one. Number one, he is a boy. Remember, every new sentence you write without a full stop is a useless sentence. Have you know that?
Yes.
The full stop is the most important punctuation mark in English. In English. Okay. He, how many people are here?
One.
So that is what? Singular. Singular what? Pronoun. Use the next line to level it. Is, how many verbs are here?
One
again. Singular. This means that the singular pronoun plus here means what? Who can tell me the word in the note we have written that this plus represents in this place?
Agree.
Oh, you are awesome. Agree. So, singular pronoun here agrees with what? A singular verb. Now, let's look at other pronouns that could be singular or plural. But because we are not sure whether the person, especially when we read it, especially when we read such pronouns, we are not looking at the person we are addressing. We are not sure whether they are singular or plural, they must go for plural verbs. So let's say the pronoun you.
Excuse me.
Yes. Now look at this. You are right. If you read this from a book, you will not know whether this you is referring to one person or two persons. That is the reason. No, you will not know. I am addressing you now. I can assume you are plural because I am looking at so many people here. But if you write it down, you will not know whether it is singular or plural. That is the law which makes it to be what? Ah. So, this could be singular or what?
Plural.
Depending on whoever you have in mind when you are using it. But the rule says it agrees with what?
Singular verb.
is a singular again?
No.
It agrees with the plural verb a.
Yes. Have you told me your name?
Esther.
Esther. Okay, tell me what's the question?
What
is the
plural verb?
We didn't say disagree. Agree.
Did
she say disagree?
Yes.
Ah, sorry, but I don't agree. Okay, in the course of the reversal, she also reversed agree to disagree.
Yes.
Oh, sorry for that. Look at what we wrote down. Plural verbs agree with what? Plural nouns. Okay. So the word disagree is not there now. Disagreement can only come when you use a singular noun and now take a singular a plural verb into it. Like, let's say, how many of you watch Jennifer? Jennifer is not, Jennifer is far away in Lagos and she has fans here.
Yes.
Jennifer diary, hands down. What is her common expression? Common expression. The common thing she says. How is you? Thank you. How is you? This how is you? What's the problem with this expression? Yes, pastor. Yes.
Pastor.
Yes.
The is.
Yes, the use of the is. I believe all of you know what I've done here.
Yes, apostrophe and S.
Apostrophe here.
And S.
And S. So what did the apostrophe swallow here?
The I.
It swallowed the I. How is you is wrong because of greatness of one word in this sentence. What's this word? Let me talk to this daughter that has been very silent looking at me saying this type of teacher said. That was what she was saying. Am I right? I got it wrong. I'll get it right next time when I want to finish what you were saying. What's your name?
Annabelle.
Annabelle. I love the name. I won't stop a child like that. Annabelle. So, there is a word in this sentence which makes the whole sentence wrong. What's the word?
If
I have not called you, thou shalt not talk. We have identified is. But that is would have been correct if that word is not there. Which other word?
How?
No.
You.
You have used deletion. You deleted how? When you said how, I said no, you deleted it. You now know the next word is what? You. Alright. So, you, if we say is, it cannot agree with what? You. It can't agree. So, the law of agreement is being broken here. And well, you can say it, thank you. Do we get it? All right, so let's go to another one. Three. Egg and chicken. How many people are we talking about here?
Two.
Two people, otherwise known as what? Plural. Everybody say plural.
Plural.
In that way, we are saying plural nouns. All these people flying about like cockroaches. They shouldn't come in here.
Okay.
Is it break time?
Yes.
Okay. I will take your time for break. Let me do this and we close. Okay? Eze and chicken. I am going to commit something now.
Wait. What's your class?
Look at this. Everyone look at this. Eze and chicken writes their notes. It's awful, isn't it?
Yes.
What makes it awful?
Because
why
rice? Why
rice?
Because it's
a give it wonderful applause. How many of look at this? Egg and chicken plural nouns cannot agree with the singular verb rice.
Yes.
So we delete the S. It should be what? Rice. Wonderful. So we put the applause here. What is this plural verb? That is how verbs agree in sentences. So when you are talking, when you are writing, make sure you have seen somewhere in your head that the noun you want to use is singular or plural. Go to the other side, click on the verb side, keep from the box, and make sure there is what? Agreement. Make sure there is what?
Agreement.
Make sure there is what?
Agreement.
Thank you, that's the end of the class. Two questions and you go for your break. I am going to be on break two. Two questions, why are you standing like
that? Are you doing that?
reflection on what you've done? You have understood everything?
Yes.
Meanwhile, has anyone learned anything new today?
Yes.
Such as? Yeah, what new thing did you learn today? Okay.
Breathless.
Pardon?
My mind.
No, 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 hold it. What are you saying?
Mindless.
Okay, the new word mindless. Prospect. You're telling me new words, I'm talking about the lesson. How verbs are green numbers, yes?
I agree. Plural pronouns.
Okay, how plural nouns and plural pronouns agree with plural verbs?
Yes.
Okay, yes.
Verbs
have numbers. Good. Give yourselves a round of applause.